The Space Wolf's Legion is known and feared as the Emperor's Executioners, and they've been brought in the Burning of Prospero to bring the wayward Thousand Suns to heal. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint one using a Mark III Power Armoured Space Marine, but you can, of course, use everything we're going to show you to paint any Space Wolf that you want to paint. So without further ado, let's get started. Like with most Space Marine miniatures, for a Space Wolf Legionary, it's best to start out with their main armour colour. So we're going to begin by painting that grey. The base paint we need for this is Mechanica Standard Grey, and as always, give all your paints a good shake before you use each colour. Now, because I'm going to be applying so much of this to the miniature, I'm going to put it on using a large base brush. And what you need to do is use the brush to get some of the paint onto a palette. It's always a good idea to use a palette for all your colours because having this means you can thin your paint down. And this is a really important thing to get a nice result on your miniature because having thinned paint with water means it dries smoother so you don't get brush marks appearing. And it also means your paint goes a little bit further too. Make sure you don't have too much load on your brush, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying this all over the power armour of your Space Wolf. Now as you go, make sure you work the paint into all the little nooks and crannies, and you're looking for a nice even coat once this is done. So if you do see any of the black undercoat showing through, just apply a second thin coat once the first one's dry. With that base coat of grey applied, we're now ready to move on to the next step, which is to apply an all-over layer of Dawnstone. Now, Dawnstone is a layer paint, so it's slightly transparent, which means that having that Mechanica Standard Grey down first of all will give us a much stronger colour now that we apply this layer over the top of it. I'm going to be applying it the same way as what we did previously, so still using the large base brush. What I want to do is get some of this paint onto my palette so that I can add a little bit of water to thin it down to ensure it's nice and smooth once it dries. So you don't need loads here. Look for consistency about like that before you start applying it. And when you're ready, what you want to do is just start painting this all over all the grey that you previously applied. And as before, if you can still see some colour showing through in quite strong patches, we've got a little bit of patches around here, then just wait for this first coat to dry and apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way. With that Dawnstone applied, we've now established the main colour for the armour, and the next thing to do is to shade it. So for this, we're going to use Agrax Earthshade, and I'm going to be applying it using a small layer brush, because what we want to do here is called a recess shade. But that, what I mean to do is we're going to paint this directly in all the recesses of the armour. So because of that, you need lots of control over the shade. So use your palette to do that. Make sure you don't have too much on your brush at once. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to paint this into all the little corners that you can find. Now, Mark III Power Armour, there's quite a lot of these. You're looking at things like little recesses just along the trim, following all of that, just running that shade into that recess to help define it there like that. So what you need to do now is just take your time doing this all across the Power Armour. Once you've finished applying the shade, you can see all the details pop out really strongly. And all we need to do now to finish the grey parts of the power armour is to highlight them. And for this, we're going to use Administratum Grey. Now, I'm still going to use my small airbrush to apply this. And the technique we're going to use here is called edge highlighting. And the way to do this is to thin your paint down so it's flowing really easily. And then just make sure you've got a good tip on your brush. So just draw the brush along, twisting the bristles together there like that. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is follow all the sharper edges of the armour. Now, on the back of Mark III Power Armour, there's some great examples of this. What you do is just gently run your brush just along the corners, just like that, so the brush catches that corner and picks it out with a nice highlight. And there you go. So all you need to do now is carry on doing this all around the armour. Once you've finished applying that highlight to the grey armour, all the grey is complete, and now we can move on to painting some of the smaller details. And the first of these we're going to do is all the brass trim. Now to do it, we're going to start out with a base coat of Balthazar Gold, then we'll shade all over these details with Agrax Earthshade, and finish off with a highlight of Cycorax Bronze. But starting out with our base coat of Balthazar Gold, I'm going to use a small layer brush for this, because there's lots of really small intricate parts here, so I want lots of control. So as before with the highlight we did previously, make sure your paint's nice and thin and that's easy to control on your palette. So thin a little bit more than that, I think. There we are, about that kind of consistency. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying this to all the parts that you want to be this colour. So I'm going to go for all the trim details, starting up here, looking for a smooth, even coat. But as you get close to the grey that we finished so far, just be as neat as you can, so that you get nice, neat, straight lines, just long details there, like that. Once you've finished applying the Balthazar Gold, the next thing to do is shade all over it with Agrax Earthshade. And you don't need loads of this, so I do recommend sticking with your small layer brush to apply it. And once the shade's completely dry, finish off the trim by highlighting it using Cycorax Bronze. And for this, you want to do an edge highlight, just like we did on the grey. With that highlight applied, all the brass parts are now finished, and we can move on to the next colour, which is going to be all the silver parts. And for this, we're going to do much the same technique. So, we're going to start out with a base coat of Lead Belcher, then we'll shade all over these details with Norn Oil, and then finish off with a highlight of Stormhost Silver. But starting out with Lead Belcher for our base colour, I'm still going to use my small layer brush to apply this, and as we did with the bronze parts, to make sure that you thin your paint down so it's flowing really easily, because you need to get around some quite detailed parts now. So make sure you don't have too much of it on your brush, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start picking these details out. I'm going to start up here on the bolt gun on the magazine, just being really careful around those bronze parts that I've done so far, and I will be applying two thin coats of this colour as well to ensure the silver's really strong before we move on. Then apply a coat of Nuln oil over all the silver parts, and use a small airbrush to apply this so that you don't lose control of the shade. And once that shade's completely dry, all you need to do to finish the silver is highlight using Stormhost Silver, still using your small layer brush. And with that, the silver's all complete. Now the next thing we need to do is to paint the bolt gun casing black. And to do that, all we need is a base coat of Abaddon Black, then a highlight of Eshin Grey. So we're going to do that now, starting out then with Abaddon Black. And my small layer brush still, so I've got lots of control here. And as always, make sure your paint's nice and thin on your palette before you start to apply it, so that goes on really smoothly. And once you're ready, all you've got to do is effectively start colouring in the bolt gun casing. Now as you're doing this, just be really careful as you work around all those silver details, just be as neat as you can around those parts. And I do recommend applying two thin coats as well. And with that done, all we need is Eshin Grey to finish off the bolt gun, and just apply it as a highlight around all the sharper edges. And with that done, the bolt gun is complete, and in fact the miniature is nearly finished. We just have a few more smaller details left to do. And the first of these we're going to do is painting the pack marking that appears on the Space Wolf's right shoulder pauldron. Now to do this, we're going to start out with a base coat of Corn Red, and then we're going to shade all the recesses with Agrax Earth Shade. After that, we're going to paint the actual marking in using Abaddon Black. But first of all, Corn Red for the actual background colour for it, I'm going to apply it this time with my medium layer brush, and we're looking to cover the entire thing. So as always, you want a nice smooth coat here, so be sure to thin your paint down so it's about this kind of consistency. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to paint it entirely on the recessed area, so avoiding the trim this time, just being really neat as you apply this. And you want a smooth coat, so I do recommend two thin coats to ensure the colour is really strong and nice and smooth as well. With that base coat applied, we now just need to reapply the Agrax Earth Shade into the recesses all the way around just between the red and the trim. Now the shade's applied, we're ready to paint in the actual pattern. And for this, you need Abaddon Black, thin down slightly more than normal, and start out with an initial line just down the very centre of the shoulder pad there like that. And from this guideline, you can then start working in the actual pattern by gradually going either side to create an upside down triangle. Once you've painted those lines and established your pattern, all you need to do is fill it in. But remember, if you are struggling to get it symmetrical, you can always use the little rivets around the trim at the top there, just as guidelines to get it neat on either side. But all you need to do now, and like I say, is fill it in with Abaddon Black, and I do recommend two thin coats. And there we are, the pack marking is complete, and all we've got left to paint are the eye lenses. And for this, we're going to go for a really cool glowing effect. And to do it, all you need is Ceramite White and Bloodletter. Now, starting with Ceramite White, you really must use a small layer brush for this, because this is a very small detail, of course, so you need to really be careful as you're applying this. So really thin your paint down a bit more than normal so it's flowing really smoothly, and then make sure you don't have too much on your brush at once. So you're looking for about that kind of consistency there. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to paint a line this colour directly in the middle of each eye lens. So really brace your hands so they're as steady as possible, and just painting the line very gently like this. Once you've done that, all you need to do is paint Bloodletter into the recess for each eye lens, still using a small layer brush so that you don't apply too much at once, because you don't want to lose control of this. And once you've done this, all you've got to do is base your miniature, and as always, I recommend you base it in the same way as the rest of your army. The base has been fully painted and a transfer applied to the shoulder plate of this Space Wolf, and with that, he's ready to go and join his brothers to bring death and ruin to the Sorcerers of Prospero. So when you're painting this colour scheme, the things to remember are, when you're applying Mechanica's Standard Grey and Dawnstone, be sure to thin those colours down and apply multiple thin coats of them to ensure you get a nice smooth result once you're finished. Now when you apply shade to the smaller details later on, be sure to pick an appropriate size brush for what you're doing. A small airbrush is ideal for these kind of intricate details. And finally, when you're painting the pack marking onto the shoulder plate, be sure to thin down Abaddon Black a little bit more than normal so that it applies easily and smoothly as you're painting the marking. And there you go, that's all there is to it. And remember, you can use what we've shown you in this video to paint any sort of unit that you want to do for your Space Wolf Legion. So whatever it is you're painting, enjoy yourself, and we'll see you again very soon. If you enjoyed that video and you'd like to see more, then why not subscribe to Warhammer TV? It's crammed with content, including loads of other tutorials. And in fact, if you'd like to watch another tutorial right now, why not click one of the links below?